Hello, everyone. Welcome to RSA Conference, and thank you for tuning in to 7 Tips for Mentoring Security Newbies. My name is Sandy Carielli. I'm the Director of Security Technologies at Entrust Datacard, and I love mentoring. I've been both a mentor and a mentee through both formal mentoring programs and informal mentoring relationships. Today, I'd like to talk a bit about a friend of mine. I'm going to call him Tom. Tom's a student that I met about a year and a half ago. Let's learn a little bit more about him. So as you probably guessed, Tom is a newcomer to cybersecurity. I first met Tom when I participated in a mentoring program at his school. Tom was a community college student, a couple of years older than your typical college student. He had recently discovered the world of cybersecurity. He thought it could be the career for him, and he really wanted to know more. There are a lot of Toms out there, and we need them. We've all heard about the skills gap in cybersecurity. So engaging and encouraging newcomers will help address that gap, right? Well, sure, except that true entry-level jobs in cybersecurity can be difficult to find. At the same time that I see people bemoan the lack of talent, I see security newbies bemoaning the lack of jobs. Very often, the journey to your first true cybersecurity job may involve multiple steps. So as a mentor, how can we encourage Tom, prepare him for the world he's entering, help him take the right steps, and position him to land that first job? And I really wanted to help him. Tom was great, incredibly enthusiastic, excited about security, and he was actually a pretty good communicator, so he'd do well beyond the technical aspects of the job. And he was curious, really curious. At our first meeting, he peppered me with questions about all manner of aspects of security and cryptography. Now, the range of questions revealed that he'd only been exposed to pretty discrete chunks of what we call the security industry. Not surprising, considering that he was just learning about it and new to it. But I realized that I quickly needed to up my game. I wanted to encourage Tom, but not overwhelm him with all of the information out there. In the year that I spent mentoring Tom, I learned a ton about what to think about when mentoring a newcomer. What did Tom need? For starters, he needed to not be overwhelmed by the number of options in cybersecurity, but pick a couple to explore. We're here at RSA Conference. If you go across the street, onto the show floor, and talk with all of the people walking the floor, the range of roles that they have is incredible. You've got your CISOs, you've got your analysts, you've got your administrators, your auditors, your consultants, your researchers, your developers, your testers. They work for consulting companies. They work for startups. They work for enterprises, for vendors. They work for the government. There really is something for everyone here. The cybersecurity industry hasn't been a single industry for years. So if my mentee wants to go into security, what the heck does that actually mean? Now, I don't expect a newcomer to have the answers immediately. How could I expect that? How could they have enough information? But I do know that if they don't think about what they like about cybersecurity, they risk a couple of things. One, they risk getting completely overwhelmed by the number of options out there. Two, maybe they pick a direction that they think cybersecurity is, and perhaps they find themselves unhappy in a couple of years, when maybe they would have been happier picking a completely different direction that they didn't really know about. Your security newcomers may not know the landscape of options out there, so it's on us as mentors to educate them. We can talk to them about the necessary skills and characteristics for various roles. We can maybe introduce them to people who hold those roles, and so they can learn more from them. And then we should also ask our mentees, ask these newcomers, hey, what is it that really excites you about security? How do you like to work? What is it that drives you? As you talk this through, you and your mentee are at the very least likely to eliminate some options and prioritize a couple of others. This is going to help your mentee decide on classes to take, decide on which events to attend, decide which blogs to read. And speaking of reading, there is a ton out there. Books, blogs, YouTube channels, free classes, websites, all sorts of webinars. When I first met Tom, I gave him a really long list of blogs and websites and people to follow on Twitter. Tom accepted my list with enthusiasm and excitement, but I realized that I risked overwhelming him with just too much information. He didn't need all that, certainly not in the first couple of weeks. So I've changed my approach. What have I done since? I try to keep the list of resources small, and I give it out in small, manageable chunks. So start with a couple of your favorite websites or blogs, and maybe 10 to 20 people maximum to follow on Twitter. If they take that information, your mentees are going to discover other people on Twitter on their own, without your help. Maybe they'll find out about new sites on their own. And maybe they'll come back and ask you for more information, but maybe they won't. Maybe they'll ask for general information, maybe they'll ask for something more specific as they drill down into their interests. We hear a lot about burnout in information security. I didn't want to overwhelm and burn out Tom before he'd even started in the industry, so I had to tread carefully. And I had to be flexible. Tom was a student, and because he was a student, I was in a position to recommend classes or trainings. What's the first thing I recommended? A communications class. Look, our mentees will no doubt have to take all types of technology classes and trainings over their careers, and they'll have to continue to update their skill sets as technology evolves, as security practices change. But good communication skills, writing, presenting, speaking, that's going to serve them well in cybersecurity regardless of the role they have. Good communication skills will help them explain the business impact of a particular vulnerability. It will help them prioritize and then explain their prioritization of different security issues. And good communication skills will help them explain to business leaders why a particular issue is critical enough to stop ship, or perhaps why it isn't critical at all. Now, about certifications. Yeah, I can hear the groans from some of you watching at home. This is a pretty fraught topic. On the one hand, the overemphasis on certifications and job descriptions is a source of frustration to many, who point out that they're not the be-all and end-all. Look, certifications alone won't prepare you for a security role. I think everyone agrees on that. On the other hand, certifications are a signal of learning, of interest, of commitment, and those signals can be particularly important for some folks, particularly those coming into the industry from unusual or disadvantaged backgrounds. So for me, that certifications question is a big old it depends. My best advice here is to be flexible. Leave your biases at the door and think about your mentee's background. What do they already have on their resume? Where are they coming from? What likely obstacles are they going to face in establishing themselves in this industry? Once you've looked through that lens, then we can consider the certifications question. For myself, I've advised some mentees to consider certifications. I've advised others against it. It really does depend. A quick word about storytelling. Your mentees are going to learn a ton from your successes and from your failures. What stories do you have from your career? What have you learned? For me, I might talk about my early perceptions of what this industry was versus the reality that I uncovered over time. I might talk about this great new product that I launched and what I would have done differently if I had to do it all over again. Tell your stories and spend some time thinking about which stories you really want to tell and preparing them and understanding the lessons that you learned. Make yourselves vulnerable. Open up, be honest, be authentic. Your mentees will learn a ton from your experiences. We've gotten through a lot so far. And we've gotten through that without mentioning the security community. But let's talk about that now. Community is really important. And here it seems like a lot of people find jobs because they know someone. Now, to be fair, this isn't just true in cybersecurity. But because there's no standard route to a career in this industry as much, it does seem more true here than in many other industries. Let's talk about events in general, and then about networking particularly. First of all, if you think that your mentee knows about all the local goings-on in your area, in their area, think again. I live in Boston. The number of events that I don't know about or even just learned about is absolutely staggering. And even though I've been working in this industry for years, I only started going to events a couple of years ago. I got involved in my local cloud security alliance a year and a half ago. I learned about some local meetups only a few months ago. You often have to know where to look. There isn't always a central repository for everything that's going on in the area. And a newcomer isn't likely to know where to look. So it's on us as mentors to share some of the options and bring them along to events that we like to attend. To be clear, I am not recommending that we tell them to spend thousands of dollars on a ticket to a major conference, to book flights, to book hotels. They're going to get a lot out of smaller local events, particularly at first. There are plenty of cheap or free events in their local area. And if they're a student, they may also find it appealing that a lot of them have free food and free drinks. Bonus. Perhaps they might want to think about volunteering for some of these events or for some of these organizations. Not immediately. They should first attend a couple of events, decide if they like the topic, decide if they like the people. But volunteering is a great way to get involved, to meet people, to demonstrate their commitment and interest. So it is something to think about down the road. For Tom, I got him a free ticket to a local conference. I encouraged him to join me at another very inexpensive one. And at both, I took him around, I introduced him to people I knew, I let him explore. I showed him the lockpicking room. He loved that. But introducing him to others was really critical. Help your mentees network, help them meet new people. Eventually, they'll have met so many people and they'll have gotten some guidance from so many people and met many more that they'll find new mentors and they'll start to fly without you, which is wonderful. So what happened with Tom? In Tom's case, he found himself with a couple of different summer internship offers, and he ended up working for his school's IT support. The last time we spoke, a couple of months ago, he told me how much he really enjoyed helping people figure out how to manage and how to deal with security, and he really wanted to explore that as a career going forward. So, what are some of the things that you can take away today in order to help the Tom that enters your life? I'm not suggesting that you run out and find a newcomer to mentor tomorrow, although if you know someone that would be a great person to mentor, by all means go for it. First things first though, you can organize. Next week, you can compile a list of some of your favorite sites, your favorite blogs, a couple of people to follow on Twitter, and make sure that those are in small manageable chunks so that when you do get asked for advice, you have those lists ready and at hand. You can also think about your stories. What are the stories? What are the things that happened in your career that can be educational or useful to your mentee that would help them learn from your mistakes, learn from your successes? Then, once you've done that, maybe in the next 3 months, you can start to look for a mentee. You can start to look for a newcomer to mentor. And that could be someone that you meet in an event. It could be somebody that you meet through work. It could be somebody through a formal mentoring program at a school. Or maybe it's even somebody that you meet online. But you find that person. And over time, you get to know them, you get to mentor them. So hopefully, within a year, you're able to start introducing your mentee to others in your network and bringing them to their first security event. I'm going to let Tom help wrap this up. When I told him that I was doing this presentation, he was so excited. And he actually wrote me an essay talking about what mentorship has meant to him. Now, I feel like I learned as much from Tom as he learned from me, but it was so gratifying to see him put into words everything that he had gotten from our mentoring relationship. And that's why I wanted to do this session today. I want others to have that experience, both as mentors and as mentees. So as a quick recap, these are the things to think about as you go about mentoring newcomers to the security industry. Thank you for mentoring, and thank you so much for joining me today.